We've got the Audi SQ5.
And this is thanks to Audi Downtown Vancouver letting us borrow this for a couple of days. This should be fun. SQ5. Of the Q5s, this one is my favorite. Andrea, what's under the hood?
A 3-liter turbocharged V6 engine with an 8-speed automatic transmission, 349 horsepower and 369 pound-feet of torque. It goes 0 to 100 kilometers per hour in 5 seconds. Comes with standard quattro all-wheel drive, and you're going to have to put premium fuel in here.
And there is one mechanical change to this vehicle that was implemented. We'll get to that about halfway through in Questions Coffee and Cars. But right now, what do you get with an SQ5? What are the key standard features?
A 10.1-inch touchscreen and a 12.3-inch driver display, wireless Apple CarPlay and wired Android Auto, 3-zone automatic climate control, Napa leather seating surfaces with diamond stitching, heated front seats, power driver and passenger seats, driver seat memory, a panoramic sunroof, foot-activated tailgate, and front and rear parking sensors.
Well, it's convenient, Andrea, that we're driving an SQ5, because what do we have to put it in?
You got to put it in S for subscribe. And if you can...
Because what are we going to put it in, Andrea?
You got to put it in S for
So it's a good thing we've got an SQ5, because what do we need to put it in, Andrea?
You got to put it in S for subscribe, and if you can hit the notification bell, you'll be notified.
When the videos drop, and then you can watch them. And also, you can follow along on Instagram. It's motormouth_Andrea. For me, it's motormouth_Otto, and the links are below. This video is brought to you by Car Cost Canada. Get the dealer's cost, list of rebates, plus discounted interest rates. Use the promo code MOTORMOUTH to become an expert member and get extra searches. The link is in the description below. Well, Andrea, what do I always say about the Q5?
You say it's always the best all-rounder.
And with this SQ5, you're moving it into the performance versions of its competitors.
Yeah.
So how does it do in that?
Well, it's not best in class in anything, in power, in space, but it does everything really well, which is why you call it the best all-rounder.
Yeah, this really is the Q5, but more power, which is the one I would buy. I know inline four-cylinder engines are very popular, less expensive, but for me, this six-cylinder, that's just perfect.
And I think that the power is sufficient in this. When you accelerate hard,
and you have the different drive modes you can put it in. You can put it in dynamic. The one thing it doesn't do really well is it doesn't provide a really connected steering feel. It's very light. This is an Audi trait we're finding with the Q3, with the Q5, and now with this SQ5. The steering is very light, but I think that's done on purpose, right?
Well, I think it just appeals to more people. I like heavier steering. You know, that X3 steering or even the GLC is kind of more what I like. But like I said, this appeals to a broad range of people, so I get why Audi does it. It's easy to maneuver. It turns easily. I get it.
This is why I call it the best all-rounder, because it's going to appeal to a mass audience. So whether you're somebody that likes performance, the engine's going to deliver that.
Yeah.
If you want it easy to maneuver, especially targeted at female buyers, the lighter steering, easy to park, all of that kind of stuff goes a long way. And that's exactly what Audi excels at. You know what's interesting, Andrea? Going on different car launches, and it used to be that a lot of brands would target BMW as their benchmark.
Yes.
And now you ask a lot of people, say they benchmark Audi. And you can see why, because it appeals to a mass appeal.
I also like this 8-speed automatic transmission. It shifts smoothly. It's very good.
So this, I think, is the secret of this vehicle. So the turbo 6-cylinder with this 8-speed works perfectly. They're perfect dance partners. So I always say, don't just look at numbers.
Yeah.
Numbers don't mean anything. It's how it actually delivers. And this vehicle is calibrated to perfection.
And if you think about it, it really has the least amount of horsepower compared to the competition. You've got the X3 with 382, the GLC 385, and even the Genesis GV70 coming in at 375 horsepower. But you've got to try this. You will be pleasantly surprised.
I remember going to the launch of this Q5, and the number one goal from the Audi designers was, don't screw it up. They kept it looking the same for a reason.
Yeah, the grill has been tweaked a little bit, the front and rear fascia, but not a whole lot even of cosmetic changes going on here. We have the black optics package that you can add to this trim, and it just blacks out the grill. You've got black window trims. I think it looks really sharp.
Now the inside, I would call this understated sort of elegance. It's a very simple, clean execution with the black and this sort of monochromatic look on the instrument readouts. I kind of like it. It's timeless.
Yeah, I like it too. I think there's some organizational issues at the center console.
That's true.
I do love Audi's virtual cockpit with the 12.3-inch digital driver display. And this 10.1-inch touchscreen is easy to use. I paired my phone like that.
Now, what do you think about the tablet stuck on the dash look?
I'm not crazy about it. I have to be honest with you. I've kind of passed it. I like it more integrated into the dash.
Now, I know in the past, Andrea, I've said I'm kind of past the quilted seat stage. Mm-hmm. It's overused, but I kind of like it in this one.
Now, you can get a package where you can opt out of this, and it gets you the front ventilated seat. So you would stick with this, eh, Zach?
Yeah, I do, because I hate ventilated seats. But I think with this monochromatic black and white look, I really like it.
The fit and finish in here is very good. We've got carbon fiber trim, which is part of a package. You can add that. I like, actually, the design of it. And there's not a lot of hard plastic being used in here.
Yeah, even the bottoms of the doors are not, you know, like the super soft, but they're texturized a little bit. Now, I mentioned when they redesigned this, don't screw with it. People like the way it looks on the outside. Yeah. And the number one thing, they love the size of this. And you can see me getting in the back seat. This thing is roomy. How does it do against the competition?
Yeah, it does better than the GLC, the X3, and the GV70. You know what beats it out? The Volvo XC60.
And we recently drove the NX from Lexus, and I found the back seat of that was tight, really tight.
Well, the dimensions of that Lexus NX are more like the Q3, but the price is definitely not comparable.
Wow. Okay, carry-on on the cooler. How's the trunk?
It did great back there. You can add some extra carry-on bags, stack them up, no problem at all. It offers 25.1 cubic feet of space behind the second row, 53.6 cubic feet of overall space, but it's not best in class back there. The GV70 offers best space behind the second row, and it's the XC60 number one for overall cargo space, and the X3 is in second.
Got to get into the center console and answer some other questions. Let's get into it.
Time now for questions, coffee, and cars.
Your questions from Instagram.
Do you and Zach think the SQ5 Sportback is worth the premium over the standard body style? I really like the look of it, but wonder if it adds to or takes away from the best all-rounder distinction. I know what Zach's going to say. You go first.
No. This is the best all-rounder. The Q5 is a great product, so you're paying more to get less.
Yeah, it's over $2,000 more for the Sportback. I think if you want a unique look, something different on the road, I get the appeal of the Sportback. However, you're losing headroom in the back seat as well as cargo capacity. So it doesn't really make sense.
Yeah, it's the same with the X3 and the X4. I don't get it myself. If you want a sportier car, buy a sportier car.
Are those the fake exhaust? Audi really needs to fix the exhaust issue of the Q5.
These ones are not fake. They're more expensive. So I went on the calculator last night to configure the one that, you know, we kind of like.
Yeah.
And you have to pay $1,800 more to get the sport exhaust. Yeah. So Audi charges you for something that should be included.
So the SQ5, yes, you're right, gets fake exhaust tips as a standard feature. And you can tell the difference because the inside is black plastic and it just doesn't look very good. Audi gets a lot of heat for this, and maybe it's time to consider a change there.
Mm-hmm.
What's new and different in this model versus the last? Love the interior, but doesn't sit as high for an SUV as my preference. Still a great sporty option. So to the exterior, mostly cosmetic changes. They revised the front grill. They changed the front and rear fascia a bit as well. And then some mechanical changes too.
There's one other one we're going to get to in a second. The main mechanical one is they re-geared the transmission to make this more lively and quicker. Now a run to 60 miles an hour, roughly 100 kilometers an hour, it takes about half a second off that time. So that's a big improvement.
Yeah, and it does feel quick. Yeah. The horsepower and the torque in this SQ5 work really well together.
Also, another big one for me is they went to a touchscreen for the communication system, which is fine, but they got rid of the MMI control wheel in the center. So BMW does both. They allow you to have the touchscreen and the wheel. Mercedes-Benz has the touchscreen command controller. Genesis has both. Yeah. Audi, they give you the touchscreen, so they ripped out the MMI controller, and what did they put in its place?
Well, they put in a whole bunch of little storage boxes, but the problem with them is that they don't really fit anything. The cell phone one, I think it's for a cell phone.
Or a pen.
We did try a pen, and it did work.
How often do you need a pen when you're driving?
My cell phone is too big for this. And then the other box, I don't know, what are you putting in it? Change?
Well, they could have really redone the whole center tray here and gone with a proper place to put things, but I don't know. So they pulled it out. They just gave us a big hole in the middle there. I would have liked to have the wheel, because I like doing it that way. I don't like touching the screen all the time when I'm driving.
Interestingly enough, Lexus and the new NX has gotten away from that completely. No more trackpad, and they've just gone to a touchscreen. I'm happy with the touchscreen.
I don't love it. The next question is our hot topic. What's this one, Andrea?
The SQ5 Sound offers a performance punch for the enthusiastic drivers out there. It offers less cargo space compared to its immediate competitors, which can be easily forgiven. How does the powertrain perform compared to the BMW or Mercedes equivalent?
In order to answer the question, I think we need to frame it with what else is out there. What kind of horsepower you get with the competition and how much they cost.
For your consideration, four vehicles for you to consider.
First up is the BMW X3 M40i with a turbocharged 3-liter inline-six, an 8-speed automatic transmission, 382 horsepower, and a starting price of just under $70,000.
Next is the Mercedes-Benz AMG GLC 43 with a 3-liter twin-turbo 6-cylinder and a 9-speed automatic transmission, 385 horsepower, and a starting price of $65,500.
The new kid on the block, the Genesis GV70, has a 3.5-liter twin turbocharged V6, an 8-speed automatic transmission with 375 horsepower, and a starting price of $68,500.
Next is the Porsche Macan S with a 2.9-liter twin-turbo V6 7-speed dual-clutch transmission, 375 horsepower, and a starting price of $70,500. So there are four compact, high-performance SUVs for you to consider.
Let's start with price. I think it's competitively priced. It's on the lower end compared to the competition. That's always a good thing. We've said that before. Audi provides a lot of good value.
Yeah, but you have to add packages like $1,800 to get exhaust tips.
True,
just saying.
True.
So I think on the performance end, the X3 with that inline six cylinder is a champ. That really is fantastic. And you know what's interesting, Andrea? Yes. So the higher end trim of this is called Technic in Canada. It's $70,000.
Yeah.
That's where the Macan S starts. Okay, now that is quite a car too.
Yeah, well, I really like the Macan a lot and would probably choose that over this if I'm spending that kind of money. But there's lots.
But that comes nothing in that.
Nothing comes. That's like base.
Yeah.
They all offer something different, and that's what I like about them all. The X3, as you said, Zach, is very dynamic. It's sporty. It's probably got the best inline six. The GLC has a beautiful interior, probably best in class, although the GV70 is right up there.
But it's the oldest.
It's the oldest, yeah.
And the GV70 is another good all-rounder, but it's an unknown for resale value, for example.
And then, of course, if you've got the budget, how about the Alfa Romeo Stelvio Quadrifoglio, a favorite of mine, with 505 horsepower, but that's getting up around $100,000.
Yeah, and then a lot of people will go, but Andrea, what about the reliability? But who cares? It's a load of fun to drive. I tell you what, let's get into the vital stats of this SQ5.
Let's start with pricing. There are two trims available in Canada and three in the US. It starts at $66,250 and the top trim is $70,850. JD Power has not rated the 2021 SQ5, but it gives the 2021 Q5 an overall score of 71 out of 100 and a quality and reliability score of 63 out of 100. Car Edge states the SQ5 will retain 45% of its value after 5 years.
Here's the fuel economy. 12.5 liters per 100 kilometers in the city, 9.7 on the highway. That's 18 miles per gallon city, 24 miles per gallon highway. solid towing capacity of 4,400 pounds, and the warranty is 4 years, 80,000 kilometers, or 50,000 miles. Okay, Andrea, two things you like to see improve.
Well, I really love this automatic transmission. It's fantastic. And the suspension on this SQ5. What I'd like to see an improvement on is, let's clean up the center console a bit. And how about we get rid of the fake exhaust pipes?
I love the engine. I love the size of this vehicle as well. What I like to see improved is, give me back my wheel. I miss my wheel. And I think they could integrate the screen into the dash a little bit better.
This SQ5 does everything really well. It's quick, nimble, and sporty.
Luxurious too. Thanks to Audi Downtown Vancouver for lending us this beautiful SQ5 for a couple of days. We do appreciate it. This video is brought to you by CarCost Canada. Get the dealer's cost, list of rebates, plus discounted interest rates. Use the promo code MOTORMOUTH to become an expert member and get extra searches. The link is in the description below.